Hello and welcome to Fierce. This program celebrates the diversity of LGBTIQ identities and perspectives. Fierce is produced in Bundjalung country at 2NCR Lismore and can also be heard on podcast at fiercefm.podbean.com and in New Zealand on Fresh FM, as well as all over Australia through the Community Radio Network. This is Peter Lena, and I want to acknowledge the traditional owners of the lands where you are listening. They took care of these lands sustainably for hundreds of thousands of years and then shared this land with us at great cost to their own lives. I want to honour and thank them for the work they have done and continue to do to care for country and to sit on the earth. I also want to thank the fairies and crones who came before us in history to fight for our human rights to love fiercely.
Fierce.
As always, you sound fantastic.
Oh, thank you.
Listeners, who's that girl? Australian cherry bomb Ray Isaac is an international and independent singer-songwriter DJ from Oz and the USA. Their debut single, I Don't Give a Damn, was number 11 on the ARIA Charts. His video clips are mini sci-fi films. The controversial video to the song Hiding won 6 short film awards around the USA. He's released music with prolific house music producers like Bob Sinclar and Robbie Rivera and more. And he's been a judge on TV's All Together Now alongside Ronan Keating. And he's just played New York Pride, as did Madonna, with his Pride song, We Stand United. This Friday on October 4th, he's in Sydney to host Minogue, the Dannii versus Kylie Minogue Party Celebration. Hi, Ray.
Hello. How are you? What a beautiful introduction.
I begin to wonder, who do you love now? Which Minogue puts the needle on it for you? So put your hand on your heart and tell us.
That's amazing. I love both. I do have more Kylie on repeat, but I do love Dannii very much. I don't think she's celebrated enough.
Well, to let the temperature rise to 100 degrees, Dannii's been chatting with you on Instagram. Is that right?
Yes, she has. You're so funny. I'm loving all the song titles chucked in there.
Oh, yeah.
Very clever.
So what's happening there? Is Dannii going to be at Minogue?
Well, I'm hoping. She's just started that TV show, The Masked Singer. I don't know if she is purposely not saying anything because she's probably afraid that if I say something to someone else, then it may cause havoc. So who knows? I know that Kylie has gone to previous events celebrating herself.
Has she? Whereabouts?
So I believe it was at the Imperial and that slide a long time ago.
Yes, I remember at the Aubrey, she watched the drag Kylie show that was on for many years after she came to that. But that was when she was like just starting out, very early on. Have you met either of the Minogues?
I actually have not.
I got to work with Dannii on Home and Away back in the day, but I've never met Kylie. And that's a good thing, I think, for my fandom.
Yeah.
You're a big fan doing this out of love for them and celebrating.
Absolutely.
Them. But also, you're amazing with your career. Let's step back in time and put ourselves in your place.
I'm sorry.
How did
you? I have to laugh every time. You're amazing.
Where are you from?
This is great. I'm from Sydney.
Sydney. Which part of Sydney?
Lidcombe.
So how did get so lucky to have this get out of my way career?
Oh my gosh, how?
Was it love
perseverance?
Perseverance. Well, was it love at first sight for your audience, or have you been shocked by what you have to do to be where the wild roses grow?
I have definitely been shocked by the things that I've learned.
Confide in us.
I guess it's not an easy road. It's about who you know, not what you know. It's about being at the right place and just working really hard to create momentum. When I was a little boy in Lidcombe, I grew up listening to R&B, pop music, but I definitely fell in love with Kylie 100%. And I also fell in love with Madonna. I remember that the first ever album that I received was the Kylie Minogue album. It's the first one with her hat on her head.
Yeah. Aww.
My parents had vinyl at home and I would listen to Madonna, Michael Jackson, and I fell in love with Madonna. She was actually my first love, I'm not going to lie. I believe it was when I was 3 years old. We were at somebody's house and they were playing music videos and Lucky Star came on. And I just remember trying to dance around like Madonna in the video. I mean, I wouldn't do it now, but back then it was cute. It was before being gay was cute. And
is that on YouTube?
No, the three-year-old, no. I believe I've put the five-year-old up. The thing with WOG families is at every party, we play the same 80s funk and 90s music. Still to this day, we play Holiday, Physical Attraction, Celebration. For a long time, all I wanted to do was sing and dance, but it was kind of frowned upon here. WOG families don't really embrace the arts. You've got to be a lawyer, doctor, teacher, whatever, whatever. Then when I turned 18, my cousin passed away from cancer and I wrote her a song called Goodbye Innocence and I sung that for her at church and that was my first ever live performance and it was the first time I ever recorded a song in the studio. I guess the response that I got from that performance really like pushed me and motivated me and I've always said it was through my cousin Diane's death that my music career was born. For years after that, you know, it's been push and pull. Not only with family, but with the actual industry, trying to break in and then being told that it's not a job or I need to go back to uni and study a proper job, blah, blah, blah. I was told that I needed to change this and change that, and then I'd go from R&B to pop. It went round and round, and an R&B song that I created ended up getting remixed into a dance track and got signed to Ministry of Sound. That is pretty much where my career took off. I performed that around Australia and in the UK. I'm not friends with all the clicky people, so I've had to do everything myself on my own, like, you know, working really hard to try and get my name out there, making sure that whatever I'm doing, I'm passionate about, you know. That's something I've definitely learned. I've got to write songs and events that I'm really passionate about, otherwise there's no point.
Well, you've been causing a commotion online with several Facebook pages, as well as websites and SoundCloud and Spotify and Instagram, to express yourself deeper and deeper into the spotlight.
Now, yes.
So you don't have a management or a label to dress you up in our love?
No, I don't. I'm going to keep laughing throughout this because
right.
I love it, Peter. Honestly, this is great. Like, I'm loving this interview. Because Dress You Up is one of my favorite songs. No, I've done everything on my own. I've had several people in the past trying to rip me off. I mean, manage me, but it just didn't work. I'm an aggressive promoter and self-manager. I would love to find someone that's as passionate as me, that believes in me as much as I believe in myself sometimes. But yeah, it's hard.
Well, it hasn't happened for Madonna or Kylie or Dannii.
It hasn't happened?
No, like they haven't found that one love, that romantic ideal to work together in that way. And then when it happened for Judy Garland, it was a nightmare. So, you know, you're probably best off being self-reliant.
Yeah, for now. I mean, yeah. I just the other day was speaking to a management company about it. I'm not going to say who it was, but it's a very well-known, famous one. And in nice words, they pretty much said that I'm not making enough money for them to jump on board and manage me. I'm like, the whole point is that I'm already out there doing my own thing. I want a manager that's going to help me get out there even more. So my point is that managers these days do not get you out there even more. Right. All they do is they take whatever you've done and they just speak on your behalf so you don't have to do it.
They know people, I guess. So they've got doorways they can open for you.
Yeah, they do actually. Because they know the people, all they do is they just take over whatever I've sort of worked on. These days, managers aren't out there looking for the gigs for you. They just manage the gigs.
Do you know anything about the Illuminati? Like, is it real?
Well, you're talking to a very sensitive and spiritually inclined person. So, yes, I definitely believe that there are dark presences within the music industry, but they're also in religious organizations. They're everywhere. No, I am definitely not affiliated with anything that is not of the light. I will not sell my soul. I wouldn't change who I am to fit in order to get that fame, no.
Well, Madonna is said to be like the queen of the Illuminati in lots of ways, doing performances for award nights that are ritual.
I battle this myself. I ask myself, well, if she really is that, why do I still love her so much? She talks about why we need guns and why there's so much killing and why we care about people's sexuality. She's pro-love, but I do understand what you're saying with some of the performances being compared to satanic rituals. That sort of stuff I definitely do not like. I'm not sure if it really is a ritual or not. I don't know. I can tell you this. I can only speak for Catholicism. They feel culty to me. Even sometimes when I go to church, I'm just like, oh my God, stand, kneel, hold it up, put it down, kiss, drink. To me, that feels culty. What I'm attracted to in Madonna is her rebellious attitude. Since I was a kid, since I saw Body of Evidence, since Erotica. Don't get me wrong, I'm not a sexually promiscuous person. I believe in finding that one true love and all of that. But just watching her rebel against what society thought women's roles should be, I don't find she's got dark music. I feel there's stories to everything, but I don't feel they're dark. As much as I love her, if I was to find out for a fact that she was a part of the Illuminati or she has anything to do with demonic or the dark world, I would disown her. I'm very spiritual. I believe in God. I talk to God every day. I'm not religious. But in saying that, Peter, this is where I contradict myself. I love her blasphemic videos. I love when she does things that are there to shock and offend. I love it. It's one of my favorite parts of Madonna.
I can tell that you're a bit hung up on the bitch, I'm Madonna.
Yeah. I am.
Did you see her at Pride?
Yes, I...
Because you were there too.
Yes, I did. I was very close up. Did you see my videos?
I haven't seen your videos. I have to have a look at those. So what was that? Oh my God. Was it good?
Oh, man. I got in for free. Where I was standing was good enough for me. I don't need to go to Madame X anymore.
But don't you want to go anyway?
Of course I do, but do you know how much it's going to cost to go there?
No.
I will not see Madonna unless I'm in the first five rows. So that's already 2,500 US. Then I'd have to fly. So that's another 1,200. And then I'd have to find accommodation. We're talking $6,000 to see my queen. Do I spend that on my queen or do I save it so that I can go back to New York and work on my career? What's more important?
So I saw Madonna in Skidney at the showground for the girlie
show. Oh my God, were you there?
I was there right near the front.
Wow.
I was very lucky because I was up the back of the dance floor type of area. And for some reason, there was all these media seats left towards the front of the stage. And there was like a big chunk of media didn't turn up. And so me and my friends, we just ran and sat down just before the concert started. And we got away with it. And we got to be there the whole time.
You know? Oh, my gosh. What did you think?
Well, I've been in the front for Kylie many times. And I've seen David Bowie and lots of amazing artists. And I've got to say, with Madonna, it wasn't as exciting as Kylie. I just think Kylie's got this really friendly, loving, celebratory vibe. And Madonna, in that show, was kind of like saying, come on, clap louder. And just being a bit bitchy, you know what I mean?
Wow. Yeah, I've heard that about her. Look, I'm going to be, you know, Peter, the thing with me is I love her. Like, you know, I love her, yeah?
Yes.
I mean, I wouldn't.
Would you sleep with her?
Sorry?
Would you sleep with her?
Not sexually, no.
No.
Yeah. I don't have it like that.
Yeah.
I love her as in I want to tell her how she inspired me to be a musician and just hug her and just. I would want to help her with her career. I would want to help write some songs for her. But I don't know. Is she a good person? Nobody knows. No one really knows her.
Nobody knows like you know
nobody
me.
Knows me. Exactly. I'm not a bitch. I just...
But Madonna likes to be a bitch.
I know. She does.
Do you think Dannii's the bitch? Is she like the evil sister? You know how in Diary of a Genie there's Genie and then there's the evil sister and in Bewitched there's Samantha and Serena?
No, look, you made a comment before about Kylie's concert. I've been to her concert. What I love, she's just always so happy and positive, and she just has this beautiful, positive energy that beams out of her all the time. She's never degraded herself. She's never been slutty or dirty or, you know, lowered her values to get fame. She's just remained who she is. Dannii, same. I've been watching her in The Masked Singer. She's just a lovely girl. They're both beautiful people. You can tell that, you know, they come from a good family. I don't think there's any bitchiness between them two. I think the media and the gays love to start shit up. I've noticed even on my Facebook, whenever I post about the Minogue party, that people just make the bitchiest comments. I'm just like, dude, like, you're a gay guy. Like, why are you even comparing two people? You know how it feels to be an outcast. Why would you do that? You know, you should embrace both of them. That's what this party's about.
What does it feel like for a girl playing New York Pride? I mean, Kylie has done it with Madonna in the last 2 years. And so have you. Wow, 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 wow.
I know.
But Dannii's only had success with Sydney Mardi Gras, which you have too. And Kylie.
Wow. I've actually done New York City Pride twice. This year definitely was more amazing than the first time. Oh, it was World Pride this year. So there was more people, more events. They spent more money on stages. I had an amazing time. The crowd was fantastic. And I got to meet the Veronicas backstage and Mel C from Spice Girls.
Wow. And so what's been your most exciting gig ever?
London Pride 2012. That was an amazing performance for me. It was the first time I had performed in front of over 60,000 people. I believe that was World Pride as well.
Wow.
London World Pride. I got to meet Boy George backstage, took photos, and I just remember the audience. Oh my gosh. It's all about the audience. When they interact and they sing with me, I just start giggling like a girl and I just get so happy and so excited. I had landed in London like a couple of months earlier, so I just settled in and I moved there actually for 2 years. And then after that, I moved to LA and New York. I'll go back to New York next year again. I've got a visa. I'm able to go there as an artist.
Wow, lucky you. Imagine you could die another day, but only have 4 minutes to save the earth. What would you live to tell?
Well, gosh, I would live to tell people that I am now the new leader of the world. Here are my new rules. Religion is abolished. And God loves you for who you are because you were made perfect. Everybody is equal. Doesn't matter what gender you are. Doesn't matter what race you are. We all have the same currency. So America doesn't bloody rip me off every time I go there. $1 is like 60 cents. It's killing me. Stop any sort of Middle Eastern and American and Russian fighting with just, you know, one touch of my hand, wave that magic wand. Everything would be at peace. It'd all be about being vegetarian / vegan, not killing animals, please. And obviously looking after our environment. So that is what I would do in 4 minutes.
Wow.
Don't you think everything would be in order then?
Well, I think you'd make a very good God. I'd love to worship you.
Thank you.
We're going to let the listeners hear your song that you've written for Pride.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about this song.
This is called We Stand United. I wrote this as a dedication to the lives that we lost at the Orlando tragedy. That devastated me. I was just so sad for like a whole week or two, couldn't shake it off, as everybody else was in the gay community, because, you know, could have been us. So I decided I needed to write something that was peaceful, that was about love, and that was about us as the LGBTIQ, etc. community coming together, being united, standing united so that we're stronger being together. There's so many people in different countries that can't be free like you and I are in Australia. Even there's still some Aussies here, a lot of wogs, you know, they're in the closet. It's very hard. So I created that track for them.
Don't cry. Let the angels wipe the tears from your eyes. Don't fear. Even though it's like the sun just disappeared. Well, they can take away my pride, 'cause I'm stronger than I've ever been before. Oh, sending words of love, proud of who we are. Stand united, stand united. Sending words of hope, stronger than what they know. Stand united, stand united. Oh.
We stand together, we stand tall. Like when they made that stance out of stone wall. That's proof that if we together, we won't fall. That's proof that if we together, we won't fall. Cause love is love, no hate, and love wins. You heard that, we stand tall. We all together, and trans lives matter. Bring our girls back.
No shame, forgiveness helps to heal all your pain. We're here, and the colors of the rainbow surround you near.
Clifford on FM.
Darling listeners, if you want to get the needle on Ray Isaac, then you can find them through their website.
Why do you say them? You can find them.
Oh, look, I'm just used to doing that because of so many people being gender
fluid. Oh, that's so cute. I'm a he.
Sometimes I get it wrong and I call people he or she wrong, and so it's just easier to use them a lot. Yeah. If you want to connect with Ray Isaac, where do they go?
RayIsaac.com or on any social media, Little Ray Isaac. Why I'm little? Because I'm short. I'm probably Kylie's height. What's Kylie's height?
She's just a tad under 5 foot. What are you?
Oh my God, no, I'm not. Shit, she's young. She's shorter than me?
Yes.
I just wanted to let you know that I am screening EVITA, the Madonna musical, 1st of October. It's in Sydney at Hoyts Broadway on the 23rd of October at the Village Cinemas in Melbourne. I'll also be DJing in Melbourne. So find me on social media and please stay in touch. And thank you so much, Peter. You're amazing. Like, you're a great interviewer.
Oh,
probably
thank
the
you.
Best interviewer I've had.
Oh my God, that's great.
Honestly.
Well, thank you for shining so bright for all of us. Listeners, I know all you want to do is get in the locomotion, head down to Skidney and go see EVITA and also play at the Minogue party. So yay. Do that and then come up here to the Rainbow, Ray, and experience us up here. It's an amazing place. Up
thank
in the Bundaberg country. Near
where
Lismore.
Wow.
Yeah.
So wait, Lismore, that's next to Byron.
Yeah, Lismore is more.
Lismore. You know what? I actually love it over there. I've been twice. It's honestly beautiful. I love Malambimbi, and we'll definitely go to Lismore this time, knowing that you're there to catch up.
Yay.
And I love this other place. It's called, I always forget it.
Bangalore.
That's it. Bangalore. Yeah.
Awesome.
That pub. Yeah, it's amazing. So awesome. I nearly was going to go to Broken Hill, the festival.
Yes. Yeah.
That's close to you, isn't it?
Broken Hill, no, that's nowhere near us. That's out in the
okay.
desert. But Maud Boat lives here in Lismore. And Maud Boat in Penny Clifford. And so
I know
many,
Penny.
So, Carlotta's on the Gold Coast, but so many of the mob are living here in Byron region and in Lismore, and they all went to Broken Hill.
That's why I got confused.
Mm.
I love Carlotta. Like, I try to hang out with her when she comes to Sydney. We went to a club together. We went to Stonewall. She's like, I love your vehicle because I've got, like, a ute.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, yeah, I'm a lesbian. in the night. She's funny. She's fun.
Quick question. You've got a ute. You said you were a lesbian to Carlotta, and you sound like you're a bit of a lesbian with love too. Like sometimes I think, like, I just wish I was a lesbian. Then I could find true love because going
oh,
in
yeah,
crap.
Me too.
Any thoughts around that you could share with our listeners?
Well, firstly, I love lesbians, first and foremost. I always say that I wish I was because then it would just be mostly about love and not lust and moving on to the next thing. However, over the last year or two, I have discovered that it's hard on lesbians as well. So I want to be like a lesbian gay all in one where I can have the love and the lust, but I still love lesbians.
So you want to be gender fluid?
No.
No.
I have a penis. I like to be a man.
Well, thank you so much for coming on to Fierce. It's been wonderful to chat to you.
Thank you. You too. Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Stay fierce.
Hello, this is Maud, and we're listening to Fierce.
My, my, my. And another queer young singer, Troye Sivan, a fan yelled out from the audience, I would turn gay for you. And Troye echoed, you'll turn gay for me? I don't think that's how it works. But then he laughed. Someone in this court is not straight. Emphasising the word court. The venue named after Australian tennis legend Margaret Court, who is now a pastor and notoriously homophobic. For example, comparing the gay lobby to Hitler's Nazi regime for getting in the minds of children and complained tennis is full of lesbians. Court also blamed the devil for trans people and said marriage equality would mean the end of Christmas. Jeez Louise.
I woke up pissed off today. And lately everyone feels fake. Somewhere I lost a piece of me. Smoking cigarettes on balconies. But I can't do this alone. Sometimes I just need a light. If I call you on the phone, need you on the other side. So when your tears roll down your pillow like a river, I'll be there for you. You gotta be there for me too.
Thank you for listening to Fierce. This program celebrates the diversity of LGBTIQ identities and perspectives. Fierce is produced in Bundjalung Country at 2NCR Lismore and can also be heard on podcast at fiercefm.podbean.com and in New Zealand on Fresh FM, as well as all over Australia through the Community Radio Network.